Yoga as we know it today is often very different from the early descriptions found in texts. Some scholars have found evidence of early yogic practice in the archaeological artifacts from the Indus Valley civilization in Sindh, which developed from about 2500 BC. However, textual evidence of yoga practice begins to emerge only at a much later stage. The first occurrence of the word yoga itself is in the Katha Upanishad, belonging to 3rd century BC. Most traditional sources of yoga are clear about one thing. Yoga is a practical discipline, and if its methods are correctly applied, they result in liberation. Before we begin, it is important to note that there is no single unifying theory of yoga philosophy. The word yoga itself has a wide range of meaning. It comes from yuj, a Sanskrit root that means to join things together. From which English gets yoke. Early usages of yoga refer to the yoking of animals to chariot, as in the Rig Veda. Yoga is often translated as union to indicate oneness. However, yoga can also involve separation, as in Patanjali's Yoga Sutra, whose aim is to isolate consciousness from everything else. Yoga seems to have started among the ascetics of northern India, who were collectively known as Shramanas or Strivers, on account of their effort to escape rebirth. Prior to the Mahabharata and early Upanishads, texts from the Vedic or Brahmanical tradition had little to say about yogic practice. The spiritual discipline of yogic practice is not a religion in itself, but traditional texts often teach its techniques alongside religious doctrine. Yoga as we know it today is derived from a variety of different sources and strands of Indian religious thought. We can divide these sources into three main categories. first category is Samkhya. Samkhya, perhaps, is the oldest of Indian philosophy. Samkhya and yoga are the same, with yoga putting Samkhya theories into practice. I will explain more about Samkhya's philosophy in a dedicated chapter, but for now keep in mind that one of the primary and oldest sources that affected yoga tradition is Samkhya. The second source that affected yoga is Vedanta. The word Vedanta literally means the end of the Veda, and it is usually understood as referring to the Upanishads. Samkhya and Vedanta are interrelated to each other, and both have a Vedic origin. The yoga derived from these two sources referred to as classical yoga or yoga darshana. The third source is Tantric source. Tantra provides a rather different notion of the nature of yoga practice, with greater emphasis being placed on the transformation of the body, rather than transcendence of the body, through realization of the spiritual identity. It is here that we find teachings on the awakening of dormant energies within the body through a range of physical and mental practices. And one might argue that contemporary yoga owes more to tantric than to Vedic sources. Despite the high status typically accorded to Patanjali,